Good morning to all of you. In our today's video, we are going to discuss subtraction without borrowing two-digit number and one-digit number. So, let us start. I hope you have practiced the subtraction properties what I have supplied you in my previous video. So, based on that also some questions are there. So, let us see. First question, we can see 38 minus 4. So, what is there? 38 minus 4. First, we will subtract always the 1's house. So, what is there? In 1's house, what is there? 8 is there. So, I told you, always you will see whether the greater number is written up or not. So, here 8 is bigger than 4. So, what we are going to do? After 4, we are going to count 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 4 is written here. And there is no number below 3. So, we are bringing down 3 as it is. So, the answer will become 34. So, 38 minus 4, the answer is 34. Next question. The question is 66 minus 6. So, we have studied in our previous class that in the number same itself, if you are subtracting, the answer is always 0. So, you are having 6 and you are subtracting 6. That means you are having nothing. That means no number is left over. So, the answer will become 0. And there is nothing written below 10th house 6. So, we are bringing 6 below. The answer is becoming 60. So, 66 minus 6. The answer is 60. Next question. 75 minus 4. Now, we know 5 is greater than 4. So, after 4, we are going to forward count. So, after 4, 5. So, only 1. So, we are writing below. In the 1's house, we are writing 1. And in the 10's house, no number is written below 7. So, 7 is coming down as it is. Next question. 74 minus 30. Now, we have studied that if you are having 0, we are subtracting 0 from any number, the digit itself will be the answer. So, here in the 1's house, we can see 4. And below minus is 0. So, 4 minus 0 will be 4. You are having 4 chocolates. You are not eating anything. That means same as it is number will come down. And in the 10th house, 7 minus 3. So, 7 is greater. So, we are going to forward count after 3. 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, 4 is coming down. So, answer will become 44. Next question. 68 minus 15. So, here we are getting two digit numbers up also, down also. Now, see 8 is bigger than 5. That means we have to count after 5, 6, 7, 8. That means 3. So, we are writing 3 in the 1's house and in the 10's house, 6 minus 1. So, after 1, we have to do forward counting. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, it is becoming 5. So, answer will become 53. Next one, 38 minus 17. Again, we are getting two digit number up also, down also. So, up we will see 8 is greater than 7. So, after 7 count up to 8. After 7, 1. So, we are counting, we are getting 1. We are writing below in the 1's house. And in the 10's house, 3 minus 1. So, after 1 do forward counting. 2 and 3. That means 2. 2 will be written in the 10th house. So, let us go to the next question. What is there? 18 minus 9. Now, here you see up there is 8. 8 is big, smaller than 9. Now, after 9, what we are going to do? We will do forward counting. So, after 9, you count 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So, we are getting 9. So, we are writing 9 here and no number is before the 9. That's why we are putting here 0. Next one, 43 minus 2. So, again we are going to do forward counting. So, after 2, you count forward count 2, then 3. So, 1. So, 1 we are writing here and here in the 10th house, no number is written over. So, 4 will come down. So, these are the very easy process because we have not yet started the borrowing. Now, children, always remember what I told, again I'm revising, always remember whenever you are subtracting, the bigger number should be written up. If two numbers are given, always write the bigger number up. I will show you again in my next video how to choose the bigger number and how to arrange like tens and ones. Let us learn first the basic concept and then we will proceed in our next video with those topics. Now, here what the things we have to recall again? Recollect that whenever we are subtracting the same number, answer will be always zero. Whenever we are subtracting zero from any number, that means answer will become the digit itself. And always while subtracting, always the bigger number will be up. Now, if like this question will come, like 18 minus 9 or 17 minus 5, if small numbers will be there, it you just go on forward counting. And the borrowing part, when bigger number will be given, I will show you how to subtract while borrowing. But this smaller numbers like 18, 17, 13, minus 5, so you have to just go on forward counting and you have to write down the number in the ones column. Not in the tens column, you have to write the number in the ones column, because one digit, that means it will be always placed in the ones house first and then only we will proceed to the tens house. So this is the basic things you have to remember always while subtraction. So I hope you have understood this topic nicely. In the next video, we will subtract and learn about the new things. Okay, bye.